I'm Luke, and after a few trips to Singapore, I have fallen in love with the place, so I've put together this handy short guide to share with you my favourite top 10 things to do.
Hello, and good morning from Singapore. I've made it! And as you can see, day one is a little bit overcast, but apparently what happens is this lifts in the afternoon. So what I'm going to try and do is do the inside stuff first and save some of the sightseeing till later on this afternoon and into the evening, because apparently Singapore comes alive at night time. I've got my guidebook and a rather little geeky list of things that I've written down that I want to do today, and all I've had to do is just rearrange them in a different order so that the more picturesque stuff comes later on.
At number 10 on my list of things to do, and probably one of the things you should do first, is head down towards the marina and jump on one of the traditional bum boats. I say traditional, but these are in fact all electric bum boats, because of course this is Singapore and nothing is quite as it seems. They will give you a great overview to the city though, and you can see some of the top sights on the way, including the world famous Merlion. Singapore is a melting pot of different cultures and religions. So number 9 on my list is a visit to one of the many temples. You've only got to walk around the streets of Singapore to discover one, but my tip would be head towards Little India or Chinatown for the best. Which leads me to tip number 8. This is Chinatown in Singapore, which is gorgeous. Although it should be called Souvenir Town, maybe. Yep, with literally hundreds of stalls and shops, you'll definitely find a souvenir here. So where do you stay when you come to Singapore? Well, number 7 on my list is the Fullerton Hotel. Even if you're not staying here, it's definitely worth a quick visit, maybe for an afternoon tea, or come in the evening and have a cocktail on the roof for some of the best views of the laser show across the Marina Bay. Number 6 on my list, shopping. It is impossible to come to Singapore and not find a deal somewhere.
I'm walking along Orchard Road now, which is Singapore's main shopping district. Probably gets its name because of the trees that align the road. One thing you can't get across on camera is the smell of this place. Now, it's a really busy, bustling city. There's people everywhere. It's hot and sticky. So what would you expect it to smell like? Well, miraculously, it smells of roses everywhere. Like, the city just smells so sweet and nice and fresh. And I wish there was a way of showing that on the camera, because it just smells gorgeous.
One of the must-visit attractions in Singapore is Gardens by the Bay, which includes one of the biggest greenhouses in the world and one of the biggest indoor waterfalls in the world.
Gardens by the Bay is a nature park spanning 101 hectares of reclaimed land in central Singapore, adjacent to the Marina Reservoir. The park consists of 2 huge greenhouses and 3 waterfront gardens. And after dark, don't miss the super trees. They're actually free to get into and quite a spectacle. Number 4, at the edge of Singapore, Sentosa.
I was really surprised to find out that Singapore had a beach. And a really good one as well.
As well as a beach, this playground is home to loads of attractions, including a zip wire.
Oh my God! Oh wow!
And at the end of the day, for something else a little different, don't miss the spectacular attraction Wings of Time. Number 3 on my list, the Singapore cable car. It's actually one of the ways you can get to Sentosa Island.
The cable car from Harbourfront Station takes you to 2 places actually. One is Sentosa, I'm going there later on. But the first stop is Mount Faber, which is a big open green area overlooking Singapore, which I'm excited about. The thing they don't tell you when you buy the ticket is this lovely glass box that I'm in is not air conditioned. I'm really hot.
No trip to Sentosa Island or even Singapore would be complete without a trip to Universal Studios. And finally, number one, the best thing to do in Singapore. Well, this one's easy, food.
One of my favourite things about Singapore is you can find street food everywhere, including hawker centres and outdoor markets and stuff. This is Lau Pan Sat, which is one of the most famous. And then in the evenings, they shut the road outside and fill it with satay chicken stalls. It's one of my favourite foods. Yum.
So there you have it, my favourite things to do in Singapore. I think you'll agree, whether you're here for a short stopover or spending a whole week, there's plenty to do. You'll never get bored in this beautiful and spectacular place.
Today we're discovering what fun could we have. No, do that again.
Just words would be good.
No trip to Sentosa or Singapore would be...
No, I'll do that again.
Tea of Singapore there.